vegetables and affordable living. Two co-owners are turning a former strip club into a grocery store in one of Madison's food desert areas. And the upstairs of the store will become apartment units. NBC 15's Cameron Kelly visited the grocery store right on East Washington.
Maria, besides a quick trip, the nearest grocery store for residents is a Hy-Vee, which is nearly a mile away. That can be a hassle to get to if you don't have a car, and people would have to pass through massive traffic. But now a long-term project to provide essential resources will come to life this summer.
Not just the food shortage issue in the neighborhood, but also housing, which is a bigger problem, not just here, but in the entire city of Madison.
Friends Jarrah Kujabi and Batch Samba will open Gooh Groceries by early summer. They bought the property, which was a former strip club on East Washington, in 2021, in an area deemed a food desert, which lacks access to healthy food options.
Most of them are low-income folks. They have challenges with transportation. So you can imagine having, a single family living in this neighborhood, having like two kids, having to cross East Washington to Hy-Vee, and then you have like your groceries in tow without a vehicle, the challenge that poses.
Kujabi says finding affordable housing is another issue in Madison.
Doing major renovation there right now to turn those units into apartments. So there'll be a grocery store on the main level, as you can see, and the upstairs would be residential.
Through this journey, the duo found construction workers who understand their goals.
They care about their community. They want to turn this building from, obviously, its blighted past into something that's good for the community.
As the project unfolded, construction workers found remnants of the past. The building began as a casino.
My favorite part of the project is the terrazzo floors that we discovered that you're standing on right now. We have them protected and covered up, but they are absolutely stunning, and they were completely covered up. You had no idea they were there.
Kujabi says there is a high presence of West Africans and Hmong people. He says the store will be a regular grocery store with options that will make people feel at home.
We'll be carrying food stuff from different parts of Africa, and also cater to the community that is here. So it's going to be a mix. You can pretty much find anything when you come here when we open.
Currently, the outside of the building is unfinished. The construction crew says they will address the physical appearance once weather permits. They hope to pave over the parking lot and add some landscape. Live in the studio tonight, Cameron Kelly, NBC 15 News.